Hello guys, it is Brandon. Thank you so much for coming back. Today is a Q&A. And our first question comes from, and by the way, I'm sorry if I mispronounce anybody's name, but I'm just gonna say, Tornike. I probably butchered that completely, but if you could wake up tomorrow in the body of someone else, who would you pick and what would you do? I don't think I would ever wanna do that, first of all. Second of all, it's just so weird. But if I, in this hypothetical situation where I could wake up in the body of someone else, I'm hoping that I could return back to myself, first of all. Would I be able to bring back the knowledge that I learn back to myself the next day? If so, I guess I would say the guitarist that I enjoy hearing the most, Per Nilsson of Scar Symmetry, I would figure out and learn, okay, what guitar techniques does he know? How does he do this? How does he apply it? And then when I come back to myself, I would use that knowledge that I've soaked up so quickly in a day and learn how to apply that in my own playing. I know I wouldn't be able to play like him because after all, it's his mind, it's his muscle memory that's done all this, but at least I would have the knowledge just to have it all of a sudden. Very hard to answer, but that's the best that I could answer. And our next question comes from Weston. He's asking, what is some music that people wouldn't expect for you to like, or guilty pleasure music, if you will? I don't really think I have any guilty pleasure music, but music that you would not expect for me to like. So you all know I like heavy metal for the most part. There's actually a side of me that enjoys easy listening music too at some points. The music would be by Michelle Toombs. If you haven't heard of her before, she's an artist that was around, I think, in the 90s. She has this CD called Listen. Very, very calming. The whole CD is calming. Constant One, that's like my most favorite. The next question is from Jay Malone. This is an old friend. He's asking, how much does string thickness affect the style of playing? I wouldn't say that it really affects it too much because you could still play whatever you wanted, however you wanted, with no matter how the thickness of strings. I think the thickness of strings is preference. I would say that it affects it just a little bit because you may have a tendency to play more of one or the other, but I kind of feel like that's kind of more of a side thing. My next question comes from Jordan Burch, which is my brother. Check out his channel. If a band you like asked you to tour with them as a guitarist for one of their tours, would you do it? Probably. I mean, I do have a little bit of stage fright, but if I could get over that, then I might. And I probably, the next question would be kind of follow up, like, well, what band would it be, you think? Like, if you could pick, you know? I'd say probably Red, because I'm more familiar with Red's style of playing. It's not too technical, it's not too crazy, and I really love Red overall. So if I had that opportunity, then yeah, I think I probably would. All right, my next question is from John. He's asking, what are your favorite Finnish metal bands? And I'm guessing he's talking about the country. I don't know if I actually have any Finnish metal bands that I know of that I listen to. If I do, I don't know. I'm not sure of their nationality. I don't really ever pay attention much to the nationality of bands. I think most bands I listen to are either from the USA or maybe the UK, perhaps. And if I'm totally missing the question, let me know. But I'm reading this as the nationality, as Finnish metal bands. Our last question comes from DJ. We had him last, the last Q&A. What's the heaviest, the heaviest band and the band that influences your guitar playing? The band that influences my guitar playing the most is probably Scar Symmetry. In fact, I would say that may be the entire answer. Scar Symmetry is probably the heaviest band that I listen to, and also band that influences my playing the most. Can you tell I like Scar Symmetry? Now, Intervals does influence my playing as well, but it's mainly the guitar solo playing, and they're not really that heavy. So if I had to combine that into two as one answer, as that one question, that's that. And then he's also asking, what's one of your non-rock influences, if any? Okay, well, that's easy, Owl City. I like that electronic kind of stuff, and I've taken bits of, you know, things from him. It's nice to mix two genres together, two or three. That way your genre, your style is more complete. It's not a copy of someone else. Okay guys, so thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's Q&A. Hope all of you guys have a great rest of the week, and I will see you on Saturday.